tweeted that I was going to make this video. And a couple of you, understandably, because you're Ezra Miller fans, and I think you see some of yourself in this altercation, came to his defense. But I'm going to explain to you in this video why Ezra Miller is not you. I would also warn anyone, no matter what your intention is, no matter how good your intentions are, what your relationship is to the other party, you should never grab somebody by the neck. That is serious. And also, physical assault is an arrestable offense. It's very bad. You know, adults really can't get into fights. Sometimes they do, obviously, but I think a lot of people don't seem to realize not only the seriousness of a physical fight, health-wise, but also in terms of legality. You know, that you could go to jail and you could be, you could have to go to court because the other person could decide to press charges. That's why the police ask you if you want to press charges. Ezra Miller better hope that this fan says now. All right, so anyway, what to do with a problem like Ezra? Warner Brothers is heavily invested in the actor, as he is a key player in not one, but two vital franchises. A position, by the way, he fought for passionately. Remember at the time, he said, they were like, how can we put you in Fantastic Beasts? I forget which direction it was. But they're like, how can you be in both these franchises? And he was like, Humphrey Bogart was, you know, let's go back to the days of, you know, the studio system where people had, stars had a home at studios. And he said, I want my home to be Warner Brothers. And, he's really a problem child, I think, in every sense of the word for the studio. I don't think this is a relationship that's benefiting Warner Brothers at all. I do see a way out for him. I see a way for them to potentially keep him, which I'll explain at the end of this video. But if I were Warner Brothers, I think they should have gotten rid of him, quite frankly, a long time ago. And this, to me, just seems to be the tipping point. Because I think that while Ezra Miller clearly has passion for what, though, we'll discuss, I think it's been crystal clear for quite some time now that he lacks the other P, professionalism. And again, I think that he's reached a tipping point with this latest situation. So as you've most likely heard, because it got him trending on Twitter, this didn't just fade away. Late last night, one of you DM'd me about it. And I was like, oh, I haven't seen anything about this. I wonder if it'll catch on. It did. And that's that really also compounds the problem for Miller. One of my favorite comments was from Danny, BTT viewer Danny, who said, J.K. Rowling sure can pick him. And this is, you know, Fantastic Beasts is really under a lot of pressure now, even more so. But I do think at least Johnny Depp delivers in terms of quality of work. All right, we're going to get to that. So anyway, what happened? Miller clashed with some aggressive fans at a bar in Iceland. It's a place he likes to go a lot. I don't think you should really have a regular schedule if you're going to be a celebrity so people can find you unless you have a security team. And Ezra Miller clearly doesn't have a security team, but he likes to go here a lot. And this time, some aggressive fans were waiting for him. And a very unfortunate moment was caught on camera. A moment, to be fair. We don't know what happened before or after. But in that moment, Miller is clearly seen grabbing a female fan by the neck and throwing her to the ground. And she's not fighting back, by the way. This isn't a two-way street, it seems, in any sense of the word. Now, Variety, one of the major trades, did some very impressive investigating, and they were able to corroborate that it was a serious incident. It wasn't just horsing around outside and it was misinterpreted. They said it was a serious incident and that it was Miller, who was upset and angry, so it wasn't like he was like having a great time, who was escorted from the bar by its security. And the fans were not made to leave. I don't know if Miller was, they felt removing Miller would defuse the situation more quickly. I don't know the circumstances of him having to leave, but he was escorted from the premises. Now, I want to be very fair here to both sides. Aggressive fans can be scary, very scary, particularly because there's a subculture of fandom that's popped up that I'm sure you've seen because they're on Twitter. I deal with them occasionally myself. They're obsessive, and this is just a small group, right? So if you're mean on Twitter, you know who you are. They're obsessive, cruel, crude, and try to be provocative by being aggressively inappropriate. But they like to laugh off such behavior, right, as fun, right, lighten up. And again, as I said, they're particularly prevalent on Twitter, and apparently at bars in Iceland. But this is where things get complicated. Miller himself seems to be part of that very same group, which might be why that type of fan was waiting for him at the bar and interacted with him the way that they did. The female fan apparently saying she wanted to play fight with him. She probably thought Miller would be in on the joke because he cultivates that kind of image. But fringe fans are fringe fans. They benefit from the anonymity of either being part of a large group, as was the situation here. It was a group of fans. Someone was filming, right? Although they did become very alarmed when that happened and stopped filming. Although I guess that's also, they should have kept filming so people would have more context. But anyway, and then when they are online, they hide, of course, behind aliases. The anonymity of the internet causes some problems. But Ezra Miller is not anonymous. Ezra Miller is playing two major characters for a major studio, Warner Brothers, and he's supposed to be anchoring franchises that are supposed to have four-quadrant appeal, which means they have broad appeal. But Miller seems set on cultivating this niche appeal, and perhaps would be better off in art house films like the one that put him on the map, and is still, unfortunately, his best work to date. I don't think he's come anywhere close to his work here. We need to talk about Kevin. Maybe the case there was that he was just very well cast. They say 90% of directing is casting. But one of the reasons, again, I wanted to make this video is to explain to those of you who wish to be professionals, not just in the entertainment business, but anywhere, but in any business, what that entails. Being a professional, especially if you want to rise to the heights that Ezra Miller is trying to rise to, you can't act like you do in everyday life when you're anonymous and have no responsibilities. And Ezra Miller has taken on quite a number of responsibilities as an artist and as a professional. I think that you have to understand that when you decide to become a professional artist for big companies, it's a bit different than just being an artist on your own. Now, no matter what those fans said or did, unless one of them struck Miller first and he was forced to act in self-defense, he should have gotten out of that situation as quickly as possible. He should have left. He should not have physically assaulted anyone, and it being a woman makes it even worse. You know, he picked one of the weakest people in the group, and that makes it seem more like predatory behavior instead of self-defense. It's why the Johnny Depp situation is so complicated. I have long advocated for Johnny Depp, but even though I'm a fan of Johnny Depp, and I think he's a brilliant, brilliant actor when he is not battling his personal demons, there's no excuse for hitting anyone. And I think hitting a woman is particularly bad because of the difference in strength, but you shouldn't hit anybody. And I think that Amber Heard, I truly believe that she baited him, all right? And I also believe that she assaulted him. But he shouldn't have assaulted her back. He should have left. And I know it's hard to leave, and I know that's a bad situation, but two wrongs don't make a right, because then they both become abusers. It becomes a toxic relationship that's a two-way street, and that's what Ezra Miller did. Instead of just being assaulted by fans, he's the one who's on camera doing the assaulting, and that makes it very hard for him to just be blameless. Now, while again Ezra Miller clearly didn't have any security of his own, the bar had security because they escorted him from the premises. So if he didn't feel he could leave on his own, he should have gone into the bar, asked for protection, because the bar has responsibilities. The bar likes celebrities coming there. It doesn't want to become known as a place where their celebrities are not safe. So they have a vested interest in keeping Ezra Miller safe. So he should have gone in there and said, I need you to protect me, and call the police, because I'm in danger and I cannot leave this bar. Never, ever handle any situation like this on your own. I know a lot of people are proud of themselves, they can get out of scraps, and they can hold their own in a fight. When you are a professional who has anything to lose, you don't get into fights. That's why lawyers have so much work, because everyone lets their lawyers handle it. But I have to say, I think Miller was unprofessional long before this. This is just the tipping point. At Comic-Con, he constantly wears cosplay that distracts instead of adds to the presentation of the films in question. I know that some of you enjoy that cosplay, and I do like seeing your fun reaction to it, but it does not help the film at all. And again, it pulls focus from what everybody there is supposed to be promoting. And so it makes Miller seem like he's out there for himself, his own amusement, his own headlines, rather than trying to be a productive professional member of the group. He does cover shoots and articles that I think, again, appeal to this kind of fan that is all that bothered him, but I think it's very difficult for him under those circumstances to be the star of family films. Now, obviously, there's all types of people who can be the star of a family film, but no matter who you are or what your background is, there is a certain kind of person who stars in family films. It has nothing to do with, because I want to make this very clear, it has nothing to do with Ezra Miller's sexuality or how he chooses to present himself. It's an appropriateness factor. And there's just certain things you cannot do, and there's certain ways you cannot be seen if you're the star of family franchises. He could still make art house films, and again, I strongly believe that that's perhaps where Ezra Miller belongs. But then I don't know if an art house film would take him, because I don't think his work's particularly good. Because Ezra Miller is presenting himself as an artist who pushes boundaries, right? But his acting has been anything but highly artistic and professional. He failed miserably to deliver as the Flash. His legs had to be, I told you this, his source told me his legs had to be digitally replaced in Justice League because his running was so bad. And that's the best they could do, by the way. It still looks bad. He allowed himself to be talked into by Joss Whedon into doing that cleavage gag for Wonder Woman, right? Gal Gadot wouldn't do it. They had to have a body double, her body double do that gag. And that wasn't a big enough warning sign, red flag to Ezra Miller that maybe he shouldn't do it either. Sure, he did the recent CW cameo, right? But that's, again, him acting more like a fan than a professional. He was the only one who was willing to do it. Again, perhaps because he's so interested in he's just playing around. In fact, I was talking to a friend of mine today about this Ezra Miller situation, and I said, well, do you want to keep him as the Flash? And she said, you know, every time I see Ezra Miller as the Flash, I have to remind myself that's not Jimmy Fallon doing a sketch. He's not professional. He also has been dead weight in the Fantastic Beasts films, showing no improvement as his role now becomes pivotal going into the third film. I mean, I can't be the only one who at the end of the last Fantastic Beasts was like, oh, he's going to be a lead now? He's horrible. And I started out as a big Ezra Miller fan. When he was first cast as the Flash, I was excited. Now, a lot of destructive behavior in the past has been forgiven because great art is produced. But Miller isn't producing any great art. And also, today, great art is no longer an excuse for bad behavior. Miller wants to be in these franchises. He wants to go to Comic-Con and be the center of attention, but it seems like he has no interest in actually delivering in them as a professional actor, which means doing good work and being able to be the major face, PR-wise, of these franchises. For instance, Robert Downey Jr. had a very troubled past. With drug abuse, he was arrested, but he cleaned up his act before joining Marvel, and he has not relapsed. So on that note, the only path I see forward for Miller is to go to rehab for anger management, because I don't believe he has any substance abuse problems. But he's out of control. He needs to clean up his act overall and go back to focusing on the work. He needs to do better work. So, what do you think? Do you really want to keep Ezra Miller in either of these franchises? Do you honestly feel it would be a loss? Are you defending Ezra Miller from being fired because you feel you wouldn't want to be fired under the circumstances? I mean, I think you need to put yourself in Warner Brothers' shoes and be like, do you really want to keep this guy? I think, as I've pointed out, multiple reasons. I think this incident and the coronavirus delays is a perfect opportunity for Warner Bros. To just let this bad partnership fade away. Oh, what happened to Ezra Miller? It just took too long? Oh, well. Unless, again, he goes to rehab and seems truly repentant and once again delivers good work. Because he's very charismatic. I think he seems like a nice person. Although I think he seemed like a nice person. I think he's so wildly irresponsible these days. You can't be that nice if you're that irresponsible. Unless you're out of control. Like Johnny Depp, who I feel very sadly is out of control and desperately needs help. The entire last Pirates movie I felt was a giant cry for help. All right, so share your thoughts down below. It's a complicated situation, so I'm interested in hearing your thoughts. Subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.